Please tell me what you have been doing before you started to write. Before Cooper's Craving,
yeah,
you actually had a career in mm-hmm. a corporate world.
Mm-hmm.
So please tell us a little bit about this transition from corporate world into a female addiction series writer.
Yeah, last year in September, I started my own business, a consultancy company within mm-hmm. HR and communication. Before that, I worked in corporate America. So I have a career working, you know, up the corporate ladder for many years, and the past years as an HR manager, HR director. And I loved it. I love working with people. I love, you know, motivating and developing people. What I don't like so much is the whole reporting structure that you find in large companies. So a lot of my time towards the end was spent on filling in spreadsheets with numbers and turning them into corporate so that they could control that I'd actually done my work. So I was sitting in my office in Gothenburg, looking into my laptop, filling in a spreadsheet or updating some kind of system and thinking, there has got to be more to life than this. So I called my husband from Sweden and said, it's now. Mm-hmm. I'm not going to do this anymore. I will resign and open my own business.
But that own business was not writing books.
No, that was on the side.
Exactly. So how this all kind of blossomed?
It kind of snuck up on me. And to begin with, I actually thought I was going to write like a book on HR and motivation and energy. And I did start the outline. I remember sitting down at street food, you know, with my computer and had everything outlined and started writing the first pages. And then I was like, yeah, but you're still stuck in the same world. I need something else. And that's when Cooper just jumped into my head. So I sat down in my office. I have a home office and started writing.